Hello, this is Will, and in this video I'm going to be doing some atmospheric effects in Nuke. This is different from previous atmospheric effects I've done here on the channel in that it's not rendered, so it doesn't do any lighting or shadowing effects. It still looks pretty good for atmospheric fog type effects. This is the reference image I'm using, and I'll refer back to this for inspiration from time to time. I'm going to skip over the setup of the depth channels. I did that in a previous video. Here, I've normalized the depth values to a 0 and 1 range. This isn't required, but it's helpful to visualize what's happening. I'm using a grade node to do this normalization, setting the black point to 5000, which is the furthest distance in this scene. Moving on to the next grade node, which is doing the bulk of the effect. I'll reset the values so we're starting from scratch. I'm using the depth red channel here to adjust the atmosphere. The first key aspect of this image is the amount of light being scattered. Scattering causes the light to become more ambient and less directional. The key word here obviously being scatter, which is when light gets bounced around in the mist or smoke or whatever volumetric medium you're working with. To increase the amount of scatter in the image, first thing to do is add an offset. This increases the amount of light ambience in the image. But this also adds a constant amount of light. When light does actually scatter, it starts to lose light as well. This loss of light happens based on depth. As the light gets scattered, the more and more it travels through the volume. In order to match this effect, we can adjust the multiplier on the grade, which dims the image further away from the camera. To control the overall density of the volume, you can use the gamma to shift the atmospheric effect towards or away from the camera. You can also do this on the grade node used to normalize the depth as a way to adjust the density of the volume. This has a slightly different effect in that it maintains a constant luminance value for the atmosphere. I've added a very subtle depth of field effect here, which I'll need to zoom in to show that it is actually there. I've done a previous video on depth of field here if you want to check that out. In this part of the graph, I do key of the luminance, splitting out the bright parts of the image into the alpha channel. I'm using the defaults of the key here in luminance mode. You can see the alpha now contains the light bulbs and some of the brighter parts of the image. And now I'm using a pre-mult to remove the rest of the image. The reason for doing this is to capture a glow in the atmosphere from the light sources. This is done using an exponential blur technique, by layering up multiple blurs on the image, doubling the amount of blur on each node. This tends to produce more realistic glow effects, mimicking the natural decay of light. This effect is then added to the final image. I've adjusted the amount of glow to suit the shot using the mix parameter. If you wish to experiment, try playing around with other types of blend modes instead of using add. This effect is looking pretty good at the moment. It matches up fairly closely with the reference, and there isn't much more to do here. For additional effect, you can adjust the color of the offset to tint the atmos, making it warmer or cooler. Adjusting the color of the multiply isn't as effective, especially when using negative values like I've done here, but that might be an interesting creative effect in certain cases. And that's it. I hope you've enjoyed this video.